Even in the halls of Asgard, the taint of corruption from the Nexus had not gone unnoticed. Whispers of war echoed throughout the kingdom. Odin called for his firstborn son, Thor, to come to the great hall. All listened in horror as Odin's voice rose.
Ragnarok is upon us.
Thor's eyes looked up towards his father as he spoke.
Father, send me to Midgard. I shall vanquish this evil in your name and let all know that none may withstand the might of Asgard.
Odin paused for a moment and then spoke.
We must release the Storm Daughters upon the Shattered Kingdoms. Their might will snuff out the evil of the Nexus.
The collected crowd gasped in horror. Even the mighty Thor found himself lost for words. His voice finally found him as he asked his father,
How will I control the Storm Daughter? They are too powerful. Their power is just as much likely to destroy the Shattered Kingdoms as it is to save it. I fear I am not strong enough, Father.
I did not call you here to lead the Storm Daughter into battle, my son. No, I have called you here to assume the throne of Asgard. I will lead the Storm Daughter to the Shattered Kingdoms. I will fight bravely, knowing that my son will watch over the kingdom should I not return.
What's up, everyone? Darth Shigong here, gaming on the dark side. GOTDS, GOTDS. Coming at you with another video on Donna Titans. This week, we're going to be going to the Norse Finish Plus event for Odin, the Allfather. Odin 3.0. He's coming back. This event starts today, June 3rd. We'll go all the way through Monday, June 7th, giving us 90 hours for my grinders, guys. We have plenty of time to do this. Quick little bit of lore here. Odin, the Norse Allfather, returns to the Shattered Kingdoms with an elite force of Storm Maidens, the Storm Daughters. Interesting. Oh, and don't forget, we also got Bo the Gods for the Finish Plus event. Very nice, since we have so many frickin' Rangers we have to worry about, right? Well, Archmages, Rangers, whatever. So now it's time to get into this thing. But before we do, guys, I need you to pay close attention to this awesome little kitty cat. Those of you that are in a rush to get into this event, this is the TLDR report. For my grinders and free-to-play players, the max gems required to be able to do this event all the way through will be about 27,000 of them. If you're using saved up relics, it'll take you 59 at a maximum, if all you get are one-star rolls, of course. You know, to buy those gems, you're looking at about $50. So $50 for this Finish Plus event, not too bad. And the souls in the event is a little under 18,000 that you yourself will have to get. The rest are included in the rewards. Now, if you want more detail on these numbers, well, hey, grab your tea, guys. You know what time it is. Sit back with my man Kermit and enjoy the show. Lots to cover, but we got to get it done quickly. So let's talk about some of the highlights here. Obviously, we've got a reskilled Odin. New skills, new synergies, new prestige, everything. Plus, we got Bow of the Gods and a new unit, the Storm Daughter. Pretty cool, actually. This is something I was talking about way in the past, man, about having some melee-based lightning troops, and we finally got them, man. So let's go ahead and cover the skills first on Odin, then we'll talk about those Storm Daughters. So Odin's skills have definitely been updated and for the better. Let's talk about them. So level 1 here, 200% Titan Troop lightning damage, 5 lightning spells, and when a lightning spell is cast, it's going to summon a Storm Daughter in the same location, a max of 5. So you get 5 of those ladies coming out. It's pretty awesome to see the lightning strikes and out they come, dude. It's actually pretty freaking sick. All right, second skill. 250% Titan and Troop armor, 150% Titan and Troop armor piercing, 2 times an attack, so that's 300% armor piercing right there, and then 300% Titan and Troop health, 2 times an attack, so you're going to get an extra 600% health. Great. Then a third skill, 35% Titan and Troop range resist, 44% Titan and Troop critical, you need that critical, every 20%, that a Storm Daughter's health is lost, you're going to get minus 4% enemy lightning resist within that Storm Daughter's aura. So that's a big deal. That helps out, especially when we start dropping some lightning spells as we keep on fighting. For that fourth skill, you have 30% Titan and Troop all elemental resist. You're going to get 180% Titan and Troop lightning damage 2 times an attack. So that's another 360% damage, which is awesome. Then you got 100% Storm Maiden armor piercing 2 times an attack. So that's an extra 200% armor piercing for your Storm Maidens. Great. Last skill, 40% Titan and Troop melee resist, 300% lightning spell damage, and every 20% Storm Daughter health lost, you're going to cast lightning on up to 4 enemies within that aura of that unit. All right, so that's pretty great. So you couple that with the loss of lightning resist, those spells are going to hit harder and harder every single time. And if it's 20%, that's a max of 5 bolts per Storm Daughter. Not too bad. All right, guys, that's pretty freaking cool. All right, let's move on. So now let's look at these new prestige skills that he's got. Power of the Storm. At prestige level 10, you're going to have 90% base Storm Maiden damage and health. Now remember, base damage happens before all the other multipliers, so that is huge. Then, from prestige level 1, on enemy death, you have a 30% chance to cast Lightning Storm on a random enemy. At prestige level 4, the Storm Daughter calls. When you call them in, you're also going to gain a Lightning Storm spell. So that's 5 of those. At prestige level 7, on a Storm Daughter's call, you'll also get 50% Titan and Troop lightning damage, a max of 5. So it's an extra 250% Titan and Troop lightning damage. And at level 10, if you go all the way with this dude, on Storm Daughter's death, you're going to summon an Omega Storm Maiden, and you'll also get 50% Titan Troop armor and armor piercing. So that's 5 times, right? So that's 250% more armor piercing, which is huge, especially in this current meta where armor piercing needs to be high because the armor is insanely high, especially if you're going up against a Minerva or something like that. Now, the only thing that kind of bites is that your Storm Daughters need to die, but they aren't really your big guns. Your big guns are going to be your regular Storm Maidens and obviously your Omega ones here causing all the damage. So just keep that in mind, guys, as we go here. Now, let's go ahead and compare some of the old versus the new here, all right, of the old Odin and the new Odin. Now, we're comparing Odin 2.0, not 1.0. That one there had the slight problem of your archers getting defensive skills rather than offensive skills. So it really sucked if you rolled a random roll with, you know, archer health rather than archer damage. So we're not even going to count that one because that one sucked. And then, you know, Odin 2.0 was better. At the time, it was pretty okay and all that. But compared to this new Odin, not even close. If you take a look at some of these numbers here. Now, my math was pretty rough. I just kind of busted it out as quickly as I could. If you want to get the real numbers, once Yuki at DOT Database updates all that stuff and puts it in there, that's where you guys want to go. If you have not checked out that website, definitely check it out. It's worth going to. I'll put the link in the description below so you guys can go to that database. It is a must-use resource for every player of DOT. All right, but anyways, back to this here. Look at the health and armor difference between the old Odin and new Odin. The new Odin is definitely a lot more tanky, but he has to be because of the increased damage that's coming at him from even defenders nowadays, right? The numbers are getting so big. Sometimes I feel like they just need to do a number squeeze. It's like they keep adding more and more numbers on top of things, and it doesn't really change the gameplay. It just makes the numbers bigger. It's the same thing as before, right? But if you look at the Titan damage and armor piercing, he does a lot more damage. Armor piercing is a lot higher. Now, I made a mistake here. It's not 580%. Actually, it'll only be about 280% armor piercing because he doesn't get that extra 300% that the Storm Maidens get, but he does get a pretty good chunk there. But like, he's not going to be your main gun per se, right? It's going to be all about the Storm Maidens. Now, I've got the Storm Maidens here and even the Storm Daughters on there. If you look at the old Storm Maidens, you're looking at about, you know, 50,000 bit of health and a little tiny smidgen of armor. These are all without relics, of course, right? The new Odin Storm Maidens, though, man, they are tanky on their own, and they've got about 500% armor to begin with, which is pretty crazy. Now, compare that to the new Storm Daughters. They've got a lot more health, and they're getting about 580% armor here. Like I said, that's before relics. So you can make them really tanky, which they need to be because they're going to be your primary meat shields. Now, Vintage, during Zalon's live stream, if you guys were able to watch it, if you haven't, definitely go ahead and watch the recording of it, made a great suggestion of bringing in some spearmen because Odin's skills affect all troops. So that would be really, really great to kind of help tie things up. You need that because you got to be able to move your Storm Maidens out of melee combat. The Storm Daughters are going to do melee combat, but the regular ones don't. All right, so you need to get them out of there so they can do some stuff and last throughout the fight because they will be your big guns. Now, if you look at the damage here, the numbers are crazy, right? A regular Storm Maiden did about 30,000 damage at about 160% armor piercing with the old Odin skills. Now, man, they're going to have about 600% armor piercing just as a base. You keep adding on to that, which is necessary. It's going to be great. Now, 201% damage, if you can get them to be critting, that's going to be really awesome too. Now, the Storm Daughters, they do a little more damage, and they have some good armor piercing, but once again, they're not going to be your main guns, guys, because they're basically doing melee damage. So they're all going to be bunched up. And if they're anything like Goliaths or Panthers, they tie themselves up when there's too many of them all bunched up. So you're going to want to kind of spread them out a bit, or at least kind of get them moving on the periphery of units so they can all be kind of hitting. If they all get in each other's way, well, it's like real life, man. You can only have so many guys hitting you at once if they're all around you. So just keep that in mind. But overall, guys, the brand new numbers are huge in comparison to the old numbers. But you got to take that with a grain of salt because all the numbers have been inflated. It's like hardcore inflation, right? The numbers are just getting so big because they have to, because they keep growing. That's it. Just power on top of power on top of power, which is something I've kind of mentioned before, and I'll keep mentioning because I think that's the only way they can go right now is up, up, and up. But in reality, that doesn't change much of anything if you really think about it. I mean, the numbers could be smaller as long as they're comparable as percentages. That's all that's really going to matter. Now it's time to talk about the brand new unit we got here, the Storm Daughters. These basically are what? The Daughters of the Storm, right? They are pretty big. They do look like they're made out of cheese. Dang. But anyways, they're these big golden Storm Maidens. They are completely melee-based. No ranged attack. Let's go ahead and look at the description that they gave us in the blog. Kind of go into more detail about these ladies. All right, the Storm Daughters. Odin has the ability to summon Storm Daughter when casting a lightning spell. Storm Daughter are more resilient, melee versions of the Storm Maidens with unique aura effects. Each Storm Daughter has 400% more health than a regular Storm Maiden unit. Each Storm Daughter has 75% armor, 50% armor piercing, and 50% all elemental resist on top of their normal stuff. And Storm Daughters are melee units. That means they have 300% melee damage and do not have a ranged attack. So unlike your corrupted grenadiers, which also were what, mostly melee damage, but they still retained the ranged attack, these ones here, the Storm Daughters, will not have any ranged attack whatsoever. So you got to keep that in mind. And another thing is, as far as I can tell so far, unless they change something between from Salon stream to now, they are basically the same as your Storm Maidens when it comes to selecting units. So you double tap on these ladies, they and your regular Storm Maidens, and most likely your Omega Storm Maidens, will all be moving at the same directions, which makes it really tricky since they are your meat shield. It would be much better if you were able to just manipulate them individually to put them where they need to go, and your regular Storm Maidens and Omega Storm Maidens can be treated as a different kind of unit that lets you put them outside of melee combat, because obviously they will do much more damage as ranged. So this is all very interesting, and seeing how it's going to go, it's going to take a lot of micromanaging using them, but all in all, a pretty cool unit. I do like having a lightning melee unit. That's pretty cool. Like I said, it's pretty interesting how they made this work, especially since Odin has to be ranged. He needs a meat shield of some sort. So it's pretty cool. Anyways, I'm looking forward to using this unit, and I'm a new Titan in battle. You guys comment below and give me your thoughts. Moving on to the milestone rewards in this event. It's got quite a bit of cool stuff. Some great relics. You know, the head of Mimir, Gungnir. That's awesome. And like I said, look at the Titans that are included in here. You've got, obviously, Odin. You're going to get Zeus. Great prestige food. And then, of course, Siv. I am glad that Siv is in there, especially at 8,000 souls. That is a steal, because I need her for my pantheon. After this event, I will be able to get that darn ratty. And that is happy. I'm very, very happy about that. It'll be super easy to get. And then, of course, at the finish plus mark here at 30,000 souls, you've got the Bow of the Gods. What's really cool about this, if you look at it, it's got 70% Titan damage, 40% all troop elemental resist, and 40% all troop armor piercing. However, when equipped on Odin, it's going to double the damage, and it's going to triple the armor piercing. So it's going to give your troops 120% armor piercing, which is great. And on Titan Critical, it's going to give you another 30% Titan and Troop Armor Piercing, a max of 15 of those suckers, dude. That's like, what, 450% more armor piercing? So, like I said, it's important to get that crit up for Odin. Keep him out of melee combat so he can be just hitting and hitting over and over again. Get that armor piercing up, and you will have more of a chance of taking out these high armored defenses, because that is the name of the game in this current meta. Not too bad, man. They did a pretty good job with this synergy. I like it. All right, guys. Now it's time for the math. But before we start, don't forget, we don't count the Portal Stone refresh rate. I don't count your battle drops. And when it comes to Portal Stones, we're always looking at a 60-second turnaround on your attacks. Obviously, using the top boost Titan at 1.4. And if we are going to count relics, we only count one-star rolls, so we're looking at the worst case possible. I am hoping that your guys' luck is awesome and you guys get 3- and 4-star rolls. That will speed things up. But hey, let's go ahead and have the lower expectations so that way you're more than happy when you score better. All right, let's check out the numbers. The first thing we got to look at is the chosen Titans for the event. With any 3-star Lightning Titan, you're going to get a 1.1 boost. 4-star Lightning Titans are going to give you a 1.2 boost. And if you got Odin, Frigg, Tarhuns, or Uranus, it's going to give you a 1.4 boost. The boost relic for this event is the Storm Candle. So if you have any of those lying around, well, you're good to go. All right, so just keep that in mind. I'm pretty sure they'll have some interesting boost packs for you guys that are interested in that and speeding through the process. Just, you know, be wise in how you spend. And don't be afraid to grind, guys, because that's what it's all about. Grind ability, save your money, kick some butt, and get some great rewards. All right, the next part we got to look at are the event rewards in this event that will help out with the grind. The developers are giving us 4,850 gems, 1,000 portal stones, that helps a ton. All right, and since it's a Finish Plus event, we will have 8 boost tokens included in the event. Now, if you're grinding and you're using them, that's going to help quite a bit. If you're just saving them up, I'll do that math for you as well. But let's first look at what the developers are giving back to us in this event. With those portal stones, 1,000 of them, you're going to get about 4,600 souls. The gems are going to give you another 3,700 souls. And the boost tokens with a 1-star roll only are giving you 3,500 souls. So for about a total of 12,000 souls, that is awesome, because that brings down the cost of the event by 40%. So 40% of the 30,000 souls you need are included for free in the event. So just for doing it. So that means it only leaves you guys with 60%, or about 18,000 souls that we need in order to be able to finish this event all the way through. So in reality, if you're going to do this whole entire thing, you're getting Bo of the Gods, the brand new Odin, all that prestige food, some great relics, all for 18,000 souls. That's a good deal. Overall, that's a really good deal, guys. Next up, let's look at the grind numbers. If we're looking at a pure grind, not using any relics whatsoever, it's going to take you 2,143 battles to do this event. That's going to cost you about 5,429 portal stones. Now, if you don't have those stones saved up, it's going to take some gems. We're looking at about 27,000 gems. Now, the grind time, if we're looking at a minute turnaround per battle, it's about 36 hours. But remember, we have 90 hours over the course of the weekend to do this, so it's totally doable to grind it out if you, well, have a very understanding spouse, in my case, that lets you just tap on that screen all weekend long. You can get it done. If you need to buy those gems, just get the 27,000 gem pack for $50, and then you can get the rest of your gems doing your dailies and by donating troops. There you go. So $50 for the entire event, really. Now, if you guys are not going for Odin and you're not going for the Bow of the Gods, but you want to save up boost tokens for a future event, maybe a brand new meta starting soon, or one of these new events coming out in the calendar that we just had pop out, well, then you're going to want to look at the second side of this table, where we're looking at the relics. Now, I know there's 8 boost relics. However, we're going to stop at number 6 at 14,000 souls, because once you go past that, the next one is at 21,000 souls. You're talking a difference of 7,000 souls. The math becomes horrible, and you're spending way more than what you're getting. Because remember, every boost relic is worth 2,000 gems. So that's what we're going to use as the basis for what we're doing. So with that in mind, 6 boost tokens is worth 12,000 gems. If you look at the table here, it's going to take you 1,000 battles, which is about 2,300 portal stones, and it's going to take about 10,000 gems to buy that. So you're actually going to be saving about 1,500 gems if you were looking at buying your own tokens. It takes about 17 hours to grind it out, and you're looking at, if you don't have the gems, spending $20 for 6 boost tokens. But like I said, it's a way better deal than spending the money on the boost tokens themselves. Plus, you're also getting some cool rewards. If you're grinding, you have plenty of fusion food for your relics and your titans. So that helps a lot, plus titan XP. All the goodies that go along with grinding, guys. Just keep that in mind. So, is it worth it? The grind for this event, if you do not have Bow of the Gods, then yes. This event is definitely worth the grind. The relics are great. The new Odin reskill is not too bad at all, and it fits very well in the current meta. It will take some micromanaging, though, so don't think this is just a, you know, let it go and auto attack, unless you're doing some really low guys. But if you're fighting some of the top titans and top defenses, you're definitely going to want to micromanage this a lot, but it will, I feel, have a chance to be able to take out some of the best defenses we have currently. It's not perfect, but it can do it, I think, just looking at the math. But of course, everything on paper isn't always the best. We can look at Progenitor as an example of that. Great on paper, horrible in actual application. But, so, yes, I think it's worth it if you do not have those things. It's good stuff in this event, guys, and it's pretty great. I'm not too sure if they're going to have another finish plus with Mjolnir. This might be the last one, so grab that Bow of the Gods if you don't have it, especially if you have a ton of Archmages. You need that extra 5-star. So yeah, why not? Go for it. And that's the video for this event, guys. Thanks so much for sticking around. If you did make it all the way to the end of the video and you haven't hit that like button, please just hit it. Helps out. Doesn't hurt at all. Just tap it. Blap. Just like that. If you comment, that really helps out with the algorithm, gets the videos out in front of more people, so that really does help. And if I've earned it, and you haven't subscribed yet, guys, and you really like my content and want to see more, hit that subscribe button. I'm really trying to get to 1,000 subscribers. That's my big goal by my birthday here in July. So if you've already subscribed, maybe share this with some other players and see if they'll subscribe as well. I got some cool videos coming out. There's some developments here at Natural Motion coming up that I really want to bring to the forefront for everybody. So yeah, definitely subscribe so you can catch those videos as they come up. All right, guys, I got to go to bed, get ready for this event. I'm finishing this video up early in the morning, man. Got to get ready to rock. So, hey, hope to catch all you guys out there playing with me, man. This is Dar Shigong, and you know how it goes. Hope to catch all of you gaming on the dark side.